Hi and welcome back to Lesson 5, Level 3. In this third video of this level, we'll continue working on our order form for the zone by finishing up our huge nested VLOOKUP function that we began in the previous video. That function will hopefully ultimately determine our unit prices for both fixed and variable pricing strategies. In our last video, we built out the four bite-sized pieces needed for our monstrous lookup function. The lookup value, our lookup table or array, our column index number, and our range lookup value. We need to test it out. If we have a 5 here for our first item number, then we see from our first formula byte that that looks into the products table, and we see that we should be using pricing schedule 1. Check. If we use that schedule 1, then we see in that price 1 table that we need the item number to look up our price. So looking back into our sandbox, we see that we're using our item number 5 for our lookup value. Check again. For our second parameter, the lookup table array, we use this choose function to determine which table to look up our price in. It says that we're to use price 1, so that's correct also. In that price 1 table, the price is stored in the second column, so 2 is right for the column index parameter. Finally, for this price 1 table, we'll use an exact match, so that's false. Cool again. Let's test out our tennis ball item number of 100. That gives us a 2 here, so looking over in this table, that's right. That means that we should be using price 2 table, and that table needs a quantity in order to determine the price, right? So back in our sandbox, we have our quantity of 60 here for that lookup value. Excellent. Our choose statement is now giving us a lookup table of price 2, so roger that. Our column index number that holds our price in our price 2 lookup table is still 2, so that checks out. Lastly, for that price 2 table, it looks like we want an approximate range lookup, so that should be a value of true out here, and it is, so we're all tested out and ready to assemble our pieces. There are a few ways of doing this. The book shows you one way, but I'll show you a different way that most beginners to nested formulas as complicated as this generally prefer. I know that these are the four parts of my function, and they all work, right? Just a footnote down here for the fourth range lookup parameter that the book comes up with a little simpler formula for it than I did in the last video. It just basically checks to see if our nested schedule number doesn't equal 1, and returns the Boolean value of true if it's not, and false if it equals 1. They both render the same result, so I can use either, but I'll use the first one since it's easier to read and goes along with the last video. Now the next step is to create our master VLOOKUP function here in the first unit price cell. Equals VLOOKUP. For our four parameters, we just want these four cells for our lookup value, or lookup table, the column reference, and the range lookup. Close our parentheses and hit enter. We normally don't get an error here when we're putting our formula together, but don't freak out on me now, I'll fix it in a second. We have our VLOOKUP function that refers to these four cells, right? These cells contain formulas, right? What we need to do next is to copy these bite-sized formulas and paste them into our big nasty master formula one at a time. Let me go over to this first parameter, go into the formula bar for it, highlight the formula except for the equal sign, and copy it into memory. Now that we have the guts of that formula in our Windows clipboard memory, we need to get out of this cell before we screw it up, so I hit the escape key. Now I go into the master VLOOKUP formula into the formula bar and see where the first parameter is referring to K6. That's where I copied the formula from, right? Let me highlight that K6 and delete it, and then paste in our formula that we still have in memory from that K6 cell and hit enter. The first parameter is now done. Let's move on to the second lookup table parameter. For our choose formula, go into the formula bar for it, highlight the formula except for the equal sign, and copy it again just like last time. We need to get out of this cell before we screw it up, so I hit the escape key again. Now I go into the master VLOOKUP formula, in the formula bar and see where the second parameter is referring to K9. Let me highlight that K9 and delete it, and then paste in our formula from that choose formula K9 cell. Before I hit enter on this choose function, however, I need to fix it a bit in order for us to fix that error that came up a minute ago that I promised I'd fix. In order to simplify and demonstrate the choose function, when I created it in the last video, I took some liberties with it to simplify it, and that's causing me an error now. This formula is currently set up to have it choose between two chunks of text called price1 and price2. However, we don't want a chunk of text called price1 or price2, do we? We need a lookup table or array called price1 or price2 or range of cells called those things, rather than just a few letters and some quotes. If I take out all four of these double quotes, this choose function will now return a table or range of cells called price1 or price2, depending on if it receives a 1 or a 2 in this first parameter, and this is the way I need it to work. Let me hit enter, and now we see that our growing nested formula actually returns value. Excellent, we're gaining on it. Let's move on to the third column index parameter. This third parameter is an easy one. It's just a column number, and it's always 2, so we can delete this K16 and just put in a 2. Let's move on to the fourth parameter. We can use either of these two formulas since they both work, so I'll use the second one just so I kind of keep myself in line with the book. Copy its formula from up here in the formula bar using Ctrl-C, now Escape. Next, go to our unit price master formula, find the last reference to K19 where I just copied that formula from and delete it. Paste in the new formula by hitting Ctrl-V, hit enter, and we get the unit price. Let's test it out. We see on price schedule 1 that the price for item 1 is $23.75. So if I put in a 1 in here, we get $23.75. So far, so good. If I put 100 in here in a quantity of 60, then I should, according to the pricing schedule 2, I should get $2.27 each. And I do. Let me change it to 250 to see if it changes to $2. And it does, so all is good. Or are we good? It works, doesn't it? Well, yeah, but we created all of these bite-sized morsels of formulas over here on our sandbox just to get it working. Once the formula is complete, we should be able to delete all of these formulas, and our master unit price VLOOKUP formula should continue to work, right? I can check this out a couple of ways. I could just delete them one at a time to make sure that my formula continues to work after I delete each one. So I'll start at the bottom. Delete, still good. Moving up, delete, still good. Delete this function, still good. Delete this function, still good. Delete this one, and boom, it looks like the formula in this cell is still needed by our formula over here in E9. Let me show you a more visual way of identifying this problem. Let me undo all of these previous deletes by hitting Ctrl-Z. Let me click on this cell, and wouldn't it be nice if there was a way to visually check to see what cells E9 needs in order to work correctly? If we look up in the Formulas ribbon, over here in the Formula Auditing section, there is a Trace Precedence. Shows arrows that indicate which cells affect the value of the currently selected cell. Bingo, that sounds like exactly what I need. Let me click on it, and it looks like this cell needs values here in A9 and C9. That's cool. Some remote tables, and this cell here in our sandbox, which looks like K5. This was a temporary VLOOKUP function that just told all of these other functions which pricing model we were to use, and most of these parts in our VLOOKUP reference the formula in this cell. I see three different K5s in this formula, so I need to go over to that cell, copy the formula out of it, and then hit Escape. Now go into our main VLOOKUP function and find all three of those K5s. Double-click on the first one, hit Ctrl-V to paste over the top of it, then repeat for the second one. and finally the third one. I'll hit enter and we get our correct answer. Let me trace the precedence again to see if there are any unwanted cell reference arrows remaining. There aren't, so we can now tidy up our spreadsheet by emptying all the cells in our sandbox, and we can now wrap this function in our isBlank function. If isBlank A9, close the parentheses, if A9 is blank, then we want nothing, so I'll put in two double quotes, comma, and if it's not blank, we want this monster. Now finish it up by putting a parentheses here at the end, and now I can copy it down. Lastly, we need a total for each of the line items on our order. This is simply our newly calculated unit price multiplied by the quantity. Copy that down. Oops, I forgot to wrap that formula in my isBlank function. If isBlank A9 parentheses, comma, double quotes, comma, then this formula. Add my right parentheses here at the end, and now I can copy that down, and it all looks good. Down here in the total order cell, we just need a formula that adds all these cells above it, so I'll add a sum function that does that for us. Equals sum these cells, and there you go. That's a good stopping point for now, so I'll see you in the next and final video of Level 3 to finish out this order form.